I'm Peter Travers, and I'm the movie critic for Rolling Stone, and so I'm here to tell you what's going on at the movies. And there's a real good one, a really good one this week, called Tyson. It's a documentary. The title doesn't lie. It's about Mike Tyson. I would not call it the objective, factual piece of reporting. I would call it Mike Tyson talking about Mike Tyson. The director, James Toback, doesn't care what anyone else has to say about Mike Tyson, because Mike himself is such a schizophrenic that he will hit on all parts of his life and relive them as they go along. Look, I can sit here and do my Mike Tyson impersonations and, you know, just try to get that highness in the voice and the lisp when he says, "I don't know, I just don't understand, but it's me and this is who I am." Well, you know, fine. I'm saying when you see this movie, you get riveted to this guy. He is fantastic. He will take you through his childhood, where his idea of a career was robbing people and hurting them. He will take you through his first fights and that he had an STD when he won his first world championship fight against Trevor Burbick and was only 20 years old. We go through his marriage to Robin Givens, her accusing him on television of being a schizophrenic and a monster. We go through his rape conviction and his 3 years in prison, which nearly killed him. And every moment of this 90 minutes counts. James Toback himself, who directed this and has been a friend of Tyson's for 20 years, is the kind of guy who could have a documentary just on him. I mean, he barely survived an LSD binge. I can't imagine anybody more ready to go off the deep end to do interviews with somebody who is already off the deep end. And yet, you will watch it, you will remember it, you will talk about it with your friends, you'll Twitter about it, you'll go on AskTravers@RollingStone.com and ask me questions about it and what it was like to interview him. I'm ready for it. To me, this is one of the best movies of any kind that I've seen so far this year.
If I have any anger, if it's directed at anyone, it's directed at myself. I might get sent to have strength.
I might get sent to have power. I might get sent to have... So, what else is out there? Is a movie called The Soloist. It has been on the shelf now for a year. Paramount Pictures seems to have not wanted to put it out late last year for Academy potential, which seems strange because it stars Jamie Foxx and Robert Downey Jr. Hey, look, I'm talking about Iron Man Robert Downey Jr. just after I talked about Iron Mike Tyson. Everything is iron. But what's The Soloist about? It's a true story. It's a guy, a schizophrenic named Nathaniel Ayers, who's homeless but a musician, who was found by a Los Angeles Times reporter named Steve Lopez, played by Robert Downey Jr. And what I like about this movie, even though it is so far from perfect, besides the two performances of these guys, is that it doesn't sentimentalize this truth. I mean, every Hollywood movie would say, oh, I found the homeless schizophrenic musician, and now because I paid attention to him, he will now be cured and wonderful, and we will all feel heartwarming. No, Jamie Foxx, bless him, plays this guy as someone we're never really going to get to. He is mentally ill. His feeling for his music is there, but no, all the compassion in the world doesn't change him. I'm saying a no-bull Hollywood movie. Who knew? All right, major part of the show, Scum Bucket. What's going in it? You know, I have many things, but this one is so special, so bad, that it makes me long for Beverly Hills Chihuahua. It is called The Informers. It is based on a series of short stories by Bret Easton Ellis, you know, and this is the guy that gave us American Psycho. I actually like the short stories. This movie is an atrocity. I mean, it is so bad. It's about the 80s when everybody just did blow, had a lot of sex, and basically thought we're going to stay young forever, and if we don't, we'll kill ourselves. I don't know why that the humor that Bret Easton Ellis brought to the book is not in this movie, but it is gone, and there are so many good actors in it. Number one in this actors is Mickey Rourke. Mickey, the wrestler, Mickey himself, playing some sort of child kidnapping pervert uncle, and he's okay in it. But the rest of it, Billy Bob Thornton is a Hollywood movie executive. Ooh, married to Kim Basinger, who used to be, 20 years ago, with Mickey in 9 1/2 weeks. A tabloid newspaper last week showed Mickey and Kim Basinger, who didn't get along when they did 9 1/2 weeks, in a photograph together, and the caption read, 9 1/2 chins. So cruel. But it is sad to see these good actors just floating around in a movie that doesn't seem to know what it's about. It is awful. Scumbucket, welcome a new friend.
If nobody tells you these things, Martin, then how do you know what's good and what's bad?
I'm Peter Travers.